Hello, Kimberly Peirce, and welcome back to TCM and our Pride Month salute to LGBTQ filmmakers like yourself. Great to see you.
Great to see you. Great to be here.
You've made wonderful films like Boys Don't Cry, a movie that you know means so much to me, Stop Lost, the remake of Carrie. And all month long, we've been talking about some terrific films directed by other LGBTQ filmmakers. Tonight is the final night of our salute, and we're kicking it off with a great one. From 1980, 9 to 5, directed by a man named Colin Higgins. Colin Higgins is a man that a lot of people don't know much about who are film lovers. So I'm happy that we're going to be shining a spotlight on him tonight and talking a little bit about him and his career. But before we do, why do you love 9 to 5 as much as I know you do?
Because it's insane and it's great. I just think the minute that music starts and you get into that opening title sequence, the energy, her voice is fantastic. And you are just plunged into a world that you know is a kind of hell, but it's like done in a funny way, which I think was a kind of brilliant way to go about this story in particular. But let's just say it's, you know, you don't necessarily need a boss to run a company, but you definitely need the secretaries. And when these women get together, they all have their axe to grind, but they don't know where to grind it. And then suddenly they see the opportunity. And once you understand that they are going to go for it, you are with them. And yeah. It is a chase till the end. I mean, I just watched it twice in the last week, and I think the timing is impeccable, the humor. Each of them is a movie star, and yet somehow they don't crowd each other out. They all take the space, and they become like this girls' club. And it is like so delicious.
Isn't it wild to think that Jane Fonda, you know, she was important to her to do a movie about a working woman or working women. And initially when she was talking to the screenwriter, Patricia Resnick, the screenplay is credited to her and Colin Higgins, the director, it was initially gonna be a drama. Can you imagine? Like, no, this movie needed to be the hilarious 9 to 5 that we know and love. And I'm so glad they changed their mind and decided to go in this direction.
It just would have been dead on the vine. It just would have been like no air at all, because it would just been like there's no subtext. It's kind of like bad on bad. But the idea that you turn it into a romp and that they're having fun, and then it even becomes kind of like a murder mystery, and then it becomes like a road movie, and then it becomes like an abduction. Like, it's just like, you know what I mean?
And I know you love Lily Tomlin and all the crazy stuff that she does in this movie.
Oh, Lily is my dream, and I just saw her in concert recently. She's just stunning.
I know there's a moment in 9 to 5 that you really love involving Lily Tomlin. What's your favorite scene in this movie?
Okay, there's 100,000 moments I love about this movie. But in particular, I just go crazy when the noose starts tightening around her and they're in the hospital and she figures out it's Skinny and Slim or whatever it is, and it's the poison, and she's poisoned him, and they do this thing where the three women crowd onto a couch and they're discovering what happened and they're watching and they realize, okay, he got poisoned, and they're watching these other doctors and it's just kind of ham-fisted, but it's great. It's just like, well, he's not doing well. Well, he's dead. And then she's like, I'm gonna definitely get fired because I killed the boss. But her body language, from that point, she's scared. But then when her friends go away, because they take them off camera, she looks at this body and you just see the wheels turning and you're just like, oh my God. And she does it. She abducts the dead body and it just gets crazier and crazier from there. Her comic timing is perfect. She's just in command.
Yeah, I think my favorite moment is the fantasy sequence of Dolly Parton where she and Dabney Coleman have switched roles and he's the secretary and she's the boss. I love all that. When you watch this movie, 9 to 5, where do you see a gay sensibility, knowing that Colin Higgins was a gay director?
Again, not to say that straight men can't do this, but I think the, particularly with gay men, it's going to be the sensitivity. I think the understanding of women. I think the divaness of all of them. I mean, because they're all bigger than life, but they all fit in the box.
Yeah.
So he's able to make divas, but also allow them to tell the story. It's not overblown. It's not too big.
Yeah,
and the sexuality, like they're whipping him and they're, you know what I mean?
Dabney
like
Coleman.
Dabney Coleman.
Violet, little coffee?
Yes, sir.
Nobody could have played this role better than Dabney Coleman.
He's brilliant.
He's a great misogynist. He's a great SOB. And he's amazing.
Yeah.
And he's so indignant all the time at them. And then they're always a step ahead of him. Then he's a step ahead of them, but then they're two steps ahead of him. And what's amazing is you kind of think with all that happens in the plot, it's got to be 5 hours long. But it's not.
Right. It's great. Colin Higgins, who co-wrote and directed this movie, unfortunately did not get to make that many movies. He only directed three. He started his career with the screenplay of Harold and Maude, which he wrote when he was still a university student, amazingly. And then his three movies were Foul Play with Chevy Chase and Goldie Hawn, this one, 9 to 5, and then he followed up with another Dolly Parton movie, The Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. What do you think when you think about someone like Colin Higgins, even though he's not very well known, what do you think his gifts are with movies like Harold and Maude and this one and Best Little Whorehouse?
Well, I think when you look at Harold and Maude and those other movies, I think you get more of the odd sensibility, the specificity that he kind of, you know, goes to the beat of his own drum. And I think there's something really profound about that, that really touched all of us and inspired us in our quest to make our own stories. Mm. So I think the deliverance of something very personal. I think when you look at a movie like 9 to 5, you know, when I'm watching it, I'm mostly thinking, not that it's so super personal, even though it is personal, but just the command. It's like this person knows, you know, what the dialogue is. They know when to go to that actor. They know how to film it. He understands the medium of comedy in a way that really was breathtaking.
Yeah. Colin Higgins sadly did die of AIDS in 1988. He was only 47 years old. That's one of the reasons why he only directed three films. But he did, near the end of his life, write and produce Out on a Limb, which was the miniseries of Shirley MacLaine and her kind of spiritual awakening. He was very close with Shirley MacLaine, so I'm glad that he got to do another project of meaning before he passed away. But I hear stories like this, and it just breaks my heart to see a man die at age 47, knowing all the other great work that he could have done.
Oh, he could have done so much stuff, and so great with these powerful, bigger-than-life women.
Yeah, it's true. Well, it's been so wonderful having you here all month. Kimberly Peirce, thank you so much for taking the time.
My pleasure. Thank you.